Good evening. I'm Lisa Collins, and it's my great honor to spend a few minutes introducing tonight's documentary, Lest They Be Forgotten. Brought to you by Levitt Funeral Services, this important documentary helps us remember our veterans and their sacrifices through firsthand interviews with those who served. I'll be joined this evening by some very special guests, and I'd like to introduce them now. First, our lead sponsor, John Levitt of Levitt Funeral Services, initiated this process and made it possible to show this film here in our area. John, how did you first hear about this documentary?
Well, we're actually members of Select Independent Funeral Homes, which is an international organization made up of locally owned funeral homes. And they initiated and sponsored the making of this with Larry and has really brought it to their members to promote it in whatever way they saw fit in the local community. It's an organization that serves, knows the meaning of service to the community, and it just was a great fit for what we believe is that we've been part of this community for 125 years now, thought it was important to do.
So why did you personally think this was important for your family to bring in?
I really think that this film portrays the stories that we see daily with families that we help at the funeral home. Every life is unique. People have stories that many of them have not told. And these films really just lead into the style that Larry uses to interview these and firsthand accounts. It really brings out the personality and their personal experiences on what happened and what they've gone through. And it just is a wonderful way for our generation and people to realize what happened 60 years ago.
Something interesting I noticed in the film, one of the gentlemen being interviewed says, it's nothing like you see in the movies, because in the movies you see the big picture of everything happening, but in this film they talk about the fact that when they went in these situations they had very limited viewpoints and very limited perspectives, and all they saw was what was happening right in front of them, and that's what they describe, and I think that's very moving.
Yeah, and you say the movies, you know, my age, I was not around during World War II, so all I have were films. And when you start seeing these people tell their stories and what happened to them personally and the cost of freedom, it puts a completely different perspective on their sacrifices. And that's why the main reason we did this is just to say thank you to the veterans back then and also now, the ones that are serving now and those that lost their lives. It's just, you know, the title says it all, lest they be forgotten. We don't want people to forget about what they did and the sacrifices that they have made.
Right. Well, the gentleman that is responsible for all this is joining us this evening, our filmmaker, Larry Capetto. Larry, I understand you've produced several documentaries of this sort. What first motivated you to start this project?
Well, you know, I looked at my life, Lisa, and I wanted to do something to thank our veterans for what they've done for our country, because I think in society today it's overlooked. As a video producer, I had always wanted to interview veterans for some reason. I've always been fascinated with history and war history and World War II. I remember as a young boy watching reruns of combat, and I just was fascinated by World War II. And I got to looking at our society and, you know, what do we do to thank our veterans? We have our Veterans Day, and other than that, there's not a whole lot that I saw. So I started 4 years ago interviewing veterans. I started this project in Phoenix, Arizona. I wanted to find a group of retirees, and Phoenix was close to Colorado where I live, so I went down there. And I began my trek of interviewing veterans of World War II. And I'll never forget the first call I got. I actually had an article printed in one of the local Phoenix papers. An editor had referred me to a columnist who wrote an article, said, filmmaker looking for D-Day vets. And that really opened up a whole door opportunity. I had over 100 phone calls from that area. And I remember the first man that called me, Jack Lindenman, Sunday morning, February 9th, 2003. My phone rings, and this man says, hi, my name's Jack Lindenman. I was at Omaha Beach, and he started to cry. And I thought, wow, that's interesting. And so that was the first of many interviews that I've done. And my father served in Korea. My uncle served in World War II, but really the motivation and inspiration behind this is finding a platform to thank our veterans, and so that's really what birthed this. It's really become a tribute, and really for me a labor of love towards those who've served our country. And that has now resulted in almost 300 interviews over 4 years, and four what I consider very powerful and very moving and inspiring documentaries in the series, Lest They Be Forgotten.
This particular one we're going to see tonight deals with D-Day and Omaha Beach. Tell me about the other films that you have made.
Well, let me just comment on D-Day. It was a very pivotal time in our history. I mean, we were fighting in Europe against the Germans, in the Pacific we were fighting the Japanese, and really the D-Day invasion, what we've heard is of D-Day, June 6, 1944, really led to the end of World War II in Europe. So it was very important, and the specific landing on Omaha Beach was very strategic in the success of that operation. A lot of us have seen the movie Saving Private Ryan. Well, mm-hmm. The first 20 minutes of that movie, Steven Spielberg really clearly depicted the landing on that beach. And I'm proud to say I've interviewed the veterans that were actually on that beach. Mm-hmm. So there's two in the series called Omaha Beach, D-Day, June 6, 1944. The third, Volume 3 and Volume 4, which I just finished before I came to Parkersburg, deals with the battle that the Marines fought in the South Pacific on the island of Iwo Jima. And a lot of us are familiar with the famous flag-raising photo mm-hmm. that Joe Rosenthal took. In fact, he just has recently passed away at the age of 94. And we're familiar with the iconic picture and the most reproduced picture of all time. And that was the bloodiest battle that the Marines have ever fought. And 8.5 square mile island. I was actually there in March, so I got some footage of the island. But that is making up volumes 3 and 4 in the documentary series.
I understand that you show these in schools a lot and start this conversation with kids. At what age do you think is most appropriate to show these and have that conversation?
Well, you know, I've talked to fifth grade classes, and I mainly will show this in a middle school or a high school. But this is appropriate for junior high, too. And I think one of my best audiences, though, were 10-year-olds. Mm-hmm. They're very inquisitive, had a lot of questions for me. Mm-hmm. But I think it's probably suited more for a middle school or junior high, middle school, senior high. And it's interesting, though, Lisa, the perspective that our younger generation gleans from the documentaries. And I might say that part of why I'm even producing this is for our younger generation. Mm-hmm. You know, we live in a blessed country. We have freedoms here that we consequently take for granted because we do live in a blessed country. This is probably the only country in the world where there's not a waiting list to get out of. And I think a lot of our young people don't realize where our freedoms came from. You know, when you have something, you don't always appreciate what you have. Right. If you don't have it, you learn to appreciate it more. And so it is with our freedoms. Freedom is not free. It's expensive. And if we really appreciate what we have in our country, you have to thank our veterans. And so I like to share that with our younger generation. And I think it's appropriate for any young person today to learn about the history of what happened in World War II.
Right. And I think, John, this is something that you're considering doing more of, getting these films into schools and perhaps bringing Larry back to spend some time in school. So if there are people out there, teachers and schools who are interested in that, you can contact Levitt Funeral Services to find out what that schedule will be. And we'll make sure that people know when we continue this program in schools.
Yeah, Larry's talked about, he's met several of our World War II veterans as he's been in here these past couple days, and he's gotten to hear some wonderful stories, as he always does, just of the firsthand accounts, and he'd like to come back and interview several of our members of our community, and we'd like to maybe get him plugged into the school system when he does that to tell our youth about this.
Right. Would you like to tell us about some of the people that you've talked to here, Larry?
Well, you know, when I came, arrived yesterday, and I had the opportunity to really talk to some of the local veterans here, and sometimes I feel like Santa Claus. When I go out into a community, these veterans, they just migrate. They come up to me, and they start talking to me, and they start telling me their stories. And I think that's one reason I've been successful, Lisa, is I do care. Mm-hmm. And I provide a very non-threatening environment for them to open up. And, you know, we had an event with John Levitt, and there were quite a few World War II veterans there. And, you know, everybody's got a story to tell. And when these veterans are gone, by the way, 1,500 World War II veterans are dying every day in this country. So there's an urgency about recording their stories. And when these veterans pass away, you know, I'm thankful that there's a legacy for their family and for those in their communities to learn from and for our future generations to learn from. Can you imagine if we had video from World War I veterans or the veterans of the Civil War, how valuable that would be? So I think as time goes by, this documentary series will really ripen and become even more valuable But, you know, the veterans here are just like they are everywhere. They're very humble. That generation of World War II veterans specifically is a very humble generation. Not one veteran I've ever talked to has considered themselves a hero. They considered the real heroes those that never came back and those that paid the ultimate price. And so it is today with those fighting and dying in Iraq. And there's two things I've learned from this project. Number one, war is hell and freedom's not free. And I think that message is heralded through these documentaries. And John mentioned and referred to, this is a very up-close and personal account of what happened in war. And our younger people are really gaining that perspective. In fact, one student told me that, Larry, your documentaries show us what war is really like and not just the glamour of Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
And so it is. It's not a recreation. It's a very unrehearsed, unscripted, emotional account of what happened. And for the most part, a lot of these veterans have never told these stories in depth. And that always amazes me, that they're telling me things they never told their wives, never told their kids. And I think that part of that success, again, is really providing a non-threatening environment. And I need to plug this guy here. It's because of John and Levitt Funeral Services that I'm here. And I want everybody to know that. And I think they really exemplify what Selected Independent Funeral Homes is all about and their commitment to this community. So, John, I want to thank you on camera for what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And I can't do it by myself. It's a team effort here.
Larry, if people would like to own this DVD for themselves and would like to be able to watch this at home or get copies of other things that you're currently working on, how can they go about doing that?
Well, I think the best resource here would be John Levitt and Levitt Funeral Services. They're equipped and they've got the availability of the documentaries. And I think the best thing to do would be to contact them directly. And you know, there's four in the series, like I said, and John has access to that information. And, you know, I as the producer of the film series, I'm just very honored to work with these veterans and to have this means available for people like John to give to their communities. You know, it's all about giving back to our communities, and really the focus of my commitment are the veterans. And I think the irony of what I do, Lisa, is the fact that I've never served in the military. When Vietnam ended, I had turned 18 and the Selective Service had ended, so there really wasn't a push to get into the military. And there's always been some guilt on my part, and I've talked to others that feel the same way. And yet I feel this documentary series is serving a purpose in our country, and I'm very proud of that. Very mm-hmm. proud of that. And but yeah, they can contact John and get the copies of the documentaries. And
And for those of you who are watching and do not live in Levitt's particular area, they're located in Parkersburg, West Virginia, Belpre, Ohio. Or you can also pick this up on Larry's website. You want to tell them about the website there?
Sure. Veteranshistory.org is the website. And on the website, it's a very informational resource about the documentary series. There's a lot of previews of movie trailers and things that I've done. And a picture of all the veterans. I always take a picture mm-hmm. of the veteran and myself at the interviews from day one. And there's a whole catalog of veterans there. So it's a really user-friendly, interactive website. And that's veteranshistory.org. So I'm very proud of that site.
Great. I'd like to thank you, gentlemen, for joining us this evening to introduce this important film. If you'd like to learn more about the project or you'd like to have a copy of your own, please visit veteranshistory.org. I'm Lisa Collins, and I thank you for joining us for this viewing.